Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Gerald Antoine. I'm an avid lover of the European Doberman. Well, you know, this is my third documentary now, and a little bit of an update on my dogs. Brody has gotten his IPO 2, and we have went for a couple of times for his IPO 3, but when you're up on that type of level, there are some things that may or may not go right. You know, these are animals at the end. Alonzo has completed his brevet, and now he is training for his French ring level 1, which he should have by the end of January or the 1st of February. Alonzo now is 8 years old, and Brody is 4, finna be 5 next month. Taking my dogs on these nice trails and walks out here in the open is just, it's therapeutic, it's good for me. It's good for the dog. It desensitizes them to a lot of environmental things that can or cannot trigger a dog's obedience or behavior. And this is pretty good for me. So you know, Dobermans are very codependent, and they want to do things with you, whether you're going to the restroom, whether you're going to the fast food In-N-Out burger, whether you're going to the parks. They want to be with you. They just want to be around you. You know, a lot of times I get calls and emails about what should I do about my dog, he's tearing up my yard. I said, well, you know, these dogs, they're not just regular household pets, they need to be worked. And I mean either taking them for long runs, doing some ball drive, ball retrieving, but you gotta do something active with these dogs to stimulate them. A lot of people fall in love with this Doberman breed because of the aesthetics, the exterior look. You got big, beautiful dogs, and people get them because of what they look exterior-wise on a tangible aspect, but they're not paying attention of the intangible. The Dobermans to me is almost like a Corvette, you know. It looks pretty in the driveway, but when they get the Corvette, they never put it on the highway. They never do what it's designed to do, which is open it up. So when people get Dobermans now, they go for the tangible beauty, the exterior, the size, the look, the intimidating factor. And I think that people have went away from what the dogs were designed for, and they become more of a household pet or talking piece. And in reality, they need to be worked because they are a working breed. And I think that now they have gotten away from what the dog was actually designed to do. The dog was specifically designed and engineered to be a personal protection dog. You don't buy a Corvette to ride on local streets. You don't buy a Doberman to just give them walks in the park. You want to open them up. Now, I love them, but you know, when you get these kind of dogs, you got to put them in some kind of active sport, whether it's rally, barn hunting. You can do dock diving. I've seen that happen now. And for me, I like doing protection sports. Now, when I talk about protection sports, not every Doberman is going to be designed for bite work. It's just like, you know, if, you know, my mother always said, if you got three or more siblings, one of them's going to be an underachiever. It's just the nature of the beast. Everybody can't be a superstar. For me, you know, these dogs, they give me satisfaction, you know, and anybody who's an animal lover will tell you that, you know, you'll probably get more love from your animals than you do from humans, and they're good to me. They give me back what I give them, and it's reciprocal, and I love the relationship I have with my animals, and I think I'll be dealing with Dobermans until the day I die. At the end of the day, I'm always gonna say, if you ain't got any working lines, you're wasting your time.